What's up, y'all? So, I am here today to give you guys a little tip or show you something that I use to take care of my hair. As you know, my hair is super damaged because of my work. Usually what everyone does is straighten out these curls. Very rarely they use my natural curls. It's usually like for campaigns or like kind of like outdoor shoots, because honestly this is more like waves right now, but when they're like super curly in the morning it's really hard to like tame and it looks very messy. So I am going to explain a few things that I've been using for the past months, and basically they work great and they nourish your hair a lot. Regarding cuts, I get cuts like once a month if it's really bad, if I'm working like consistently and they're damaging my hair a lot, but usually it's maybe once every 2 months. So without further ado, let's go. Starting off with this, I don't know how to make it focus, but it's basically Pureology mask. Pureology mask, it's called Superfood. It is a strengthening mask for your hair. You just have to leave in for like 5-10 minutes. It's with goji berry and olive oil, so that works great. So what I'm gonna do, it's a new one. I ran out so fast of my old one. Smells very refreshing. You're gonna just like put it from your roots down to your ends. What I like to do is split the hair, so I make sure I get every part. And yeah, basically my hair, guys, was so freaking long before I started modeling. It was until maybe like under my boob, because I was a young girl studying. I actually studied acting in New York, so it was actually, didn't really care about how I looked. I was like this free spirit running around, didn't do my makeup, didn't do my hair. I didn't know how to like take care of my skin. Like, I honestly, I swear to you, I probably had like 5 things for hair and makeup. I mean, skincare, like makeup, I started doing my makeup when I met this friend of mine who was like, "You don't go out, you're so pretty, like in New York, all the girls go out with promoters." And that's when I got into the nightlife and I started going out. Guys, what the hell? started going out, doing my makeup. When I look back on the pictures, I'm like, Jesus, was I really wearing that? But anyways, when I got signed in LA with Wilhelmina, I was like, my manager helped me out. She was like, you should wear this and you should do your makeup this way. And I still keep it natural throughout my years. Like, I put makeup on and people are like, do you have makeup? And I'm like,
yeah, like I spend 2 hours doing it.
But yeah, I usually don't do a lot, but with hair, it's just so important. I just want it to be healthy, and like, I am trying to grow it out a little. So that's why I have been experimenting so much with like products and seeing what actually helps. So on top of like all the hair products and all the hair stuff I use, I definitely have been also experimenting with vitamins and seeing what works best. But also find a really good salon and a person who cuts your hair, because it's not a lie what they say, like people who have the hand will make your hair grow. So we're nearly done here. I like to spend time, because this is a great mask, so I like to take my time and make sure that every area is covered. I look crazy. But you know, you're at home, you want to like take your time for self-care. You want to make this hair grow. Massage it a little in the top of your roots too. I don't know if you can like see it through the camera. It does get a little stiff and looks like crazy, but trust me guys, it's gonna work. Yeah, so you know, everyone always asks me like, how do I know what I'm using? Like, of course I'm not telling you at any point like this is what you have to use, like starting from makeup, ending at diet, you know, like these are the things that work for me. And as models, we have to like keep that certain look and keep that certain form and figure. And of course there's more pressure than like normal people, so we do, like speaking for myself, like I do put a lot of effort to find products and find makeup that works best and find skincare that makes my skin like glowy in the morning, because you know, sometimes your call times are like at 6 a.m. and they just expect you to look like fresh and you've just come from the beach. So there's a lot of work and there's a lot of like expectations that come from us. So that's something that, you know, people have to realize, because we don't wake up and look amazing and our hair is healthy and shiny and our skin's like natural, glowy and tan. Like,
hell no.
We're all people and we're all humans, and I wake up looking like shit sometimes, and I mean most of the times. And you know, if I drink too much water at night, I get puffy. So it's like I have to drink water, and then I can drink water at night because my skin's gonna get puffy. So there's like certain aspects that I had to kind of like, okay, I want to drink water at night because I'm freaking thirsty. So what's something I can do to not make me look like puffy in the morning? Yeah, a lot of things that we do kind of like explore in our whole period of work and time. And that's why, you know, there's me here trying to tell you guys what to do and how to do it, because I feel like I tried out more products than an average human, which is like a normal thing to say. Whoever's suffering with whatever problem they have, like me, about like dry hair and like keeping it curly. I mean, also my hair sheds a lot, like it's stress or sometimes something doesn't work or whatever. This whole corona situation is like also stressing, you know, because we are like stuck here now without work. Like a lot of brands are not working. I mean, a lot of things are closed, and in no mean I am saying that, you know, I'm more luckier than others, but it is this way, and I'm just being kind of honest in terms of like, you know, there's some people who have families of four or five and cannot provide for them now. And it's just a really horrible time, because this crisis, some people, you know, if you talk to 50 people, they have 50 opinions and it's okay. It's just some people don't realize it yet. Some people are too hopeful or too naive, or some people are too pessimistic. And you just like have to find this like mid balance, because no one knows what's gonna happen, to be honest. Like, no one freaking knows. And I'm just here to tell you my story. So in no sorts I want to say that, you know, we are having a better life. Like, no, I'm stuck here. I'm currently in Germany, and my plan was to go back to LA in May. I was there for 3 months in LA, building new clients, building new relationships, working my ass off, like 8 to 10 hours a day. Like, you don't have time to start a YouTube channel like you wanted, or like learn a language like you wanted, or do all of these things, which currently I am doing, so I'm grateful for that. It's kind of like a break for me. But others, of course, they need to work, because people live check by check, and you know, you take all these people across the country and it's just freaking horrible because what they're going through. And there's a lot of ways to help, and I've been on my Instagram, I posted a highlight bubble how to donate and help, because you know, everything counts. And if you are a bit more fortunate and lucky to sit at home and be like, okay, you know, when this all blows over, it'll be fine and you'll go back to it, like, please help those out who really don't think it's gonna be fine and who really don't want to wake up in the morning and work out, or don't want to do a face mask because they're like, fuck this shit. Sorry, excuse my language. But, you know, that's the reality, and we always have to just be there for other people. And we, no one knows when this will be over. So the most I can do from my side is be there for you and motivate people who want to be motivated and show you everything that I wanted to show this whole time. Who knows when I go back, if my agency will be open, who knows if I will have the same clients, who will file for bankruptcy, who will not be existent, you know, like a lot of companies close because if they don't work for three months, you know, a lot of companies file for bankruptcy. I had this in the past without a crisis of like, you work for a company and then they out of the blue file for bankruptcy, and then you're like, oh, okay, like I thought everything was fine. So it happens, but now it's hit really hard, and I'm sure it's gonna happen like really bad. So I don't know, it's just crazy for me to see people, you know, still going out and still like being with friends, or you know, not taking this seriously, because we want this to be over. So just like, not, don't only like not think about yourself, but think about other people, because I'm staying at home even though, you know, I might have it and I don't have a symptom, but I'm not going to go out and be like, you know, I'm fine and others are, everything will be fine. Like, you never know. Basically, I can keep on talking about this, but there's no way for me to work. Even from home, like, you know, if you reach out to certain brands to work with them, they're suffering. So it's going to be tough for them to pay models and work with them if they don't have the people buying from them. They don't have this income, the regular income. Everything's just stopped. So people are not in the mood for like shopping. I mean, even shops are closed, but even like online, doing like a haul of, hey, this is what I'm wearing today, and like, if you want to buy this, it's from like this smart brand or this, like, you never know what the person's thinking. Like, oh, she's shopping online, I can't even afford like food, for example. So I don't know, you know, it's a tough time. Like, you sit there and you're thinking, what is the right thing to do? But I think the best thing for us to do is all be there for each other, you know. Everyone's more active on social media, so that's the best way for us to show each other our support and our love. And like, I've been posting workouts and whatever, like whatever motivates people, and I want to be there for you, and that's why here I am, like, talking about my problems. But guys, yeah, it's just so tough. I don't think I will be going anywhere in May. I was planning to book my ticket to LA now, but I don't want to risk it. Basically just gonna wait and see, you know. You have like this big plan, like for example, my plan was to save and to invest this money in like a house at the end of the year, and it's not gonna happen because you basically have your savings and you have to live off these savings right now for like 3-4 months, and then, you know, you have to start all over again. I'm sure everyone's plan is paused and we have to like reroute, and it's okay because, you know, shit happens while you're like, you know, if you're walking down a street and the road's blocked, you have to take a detour, but you'll get there in the end. It wasn't the route you planned, but you will get there, and it will take longer, but that's life. Hey, you know, shit happens in life and you have to take a detour, or you have to reroute your journey, and that's okay. So I'm happy on one side, and I'm really upset and frustrated on the other. I'm more sad and anxious that I can't really do much for other people. The only way I can do it is by giving money, and that really frustrates me because it's like, there's so many things in the world, and it's like, what do we freaking do, you know? But yeah, there's a lot of mixed feelings, and it's okay to wake up in the morning and cry, and then it's okay to wake up angry, and it's okay to wake up happy, and it's like, I'm a Gemini too, so my freaking moods are like... yeah, just breathe, keep calm, meditate, you know, that's all we can do. We're stuck at home, and the best thing every person can do is stay at home. Really, there's just like, if we all stayed home, if every single person in the world stayed at home, we could fight this so much faster and we could go back to our normal lives. So I just can't emphasize that more. Stay home. Anyways, it's been 5 minutes, even longer. I'm talking and talking, so let's go to the shower, wash this off. I'm gonna show you some of my shampoos and conditioner, not some, my favorite shampoo and conditioner that I've been using, and let's get this washed. So, welcome to my dot corner. So, we are in the shower and making this as real as possible. Just gonna zoom in a little bit so it's okay for everyone. So we're washing this off. It doesn't get in your mouth. And the hair is so soft right now. Super soft. It's my Kiehls. Mistake. My shampoo is the Moroccan. Make sure you really get in the roots because of the mask we have.
Six and a half hours later.
Let me see if I can make it better. Okay, here, it's a bit better. The most important step for me is the conditioner. This is where
my Kiehls come from.
I love Kiehls. I also use their shampoo from the same series. It smells incredible. The Moroccan oil doesn't smell as great. I mean, it smells fine, but...
So much later that the old narrator got tired of waiting and they had to hire a new one.
Tomorrow for sure. Later.
So guys, we're back in our little room. Hope it didn't get too steamy for you all. So basically, I'm back. I didn't even dry my hair. I'm just gonna like brush it through while it's still like wet. Guys, I really suggest you getting this because it has helped my hair like not break. Yeah, it has helped my hair not break. It's very soft, so when you like put a towel, it's just like not heavy that it like rips your hair out. So I just leave it in this little thing for a bit until it like dries off a little bit. Just maybe 10 to 15 minutes. I walk around in it. So see you in 10. Okay guys, and we're back. It's been like 15 minutes for me. I did my brows and I put this cream on. I don't know if you see my face is glowing, but I'm just gonna put this recommendation in. This is she, but it's the Skin Food. It just says face cream. It's very, very thick, but I woke up with really dry skin, so it's glowing and I feel so good right now. Anyways, back to hair. So I'm gonna take this off, slowly like massage it in, and then you're gonna brush it off again. I just use this like Maris Muller brush. It's like super good for the hair. Because I'm home, I'm gonna let it air dry, but I usually use the, what's it called? Like the, I'm gonna put it in the title. The hair dryer with the, for the curls, it's gonna be here, the name. And that helps me like not ruin my curls and keep them healthy and curly. So we've brushed it off. My ends feel like super nourished. That's amazing because I usually wash it with different shampoos, and you know when you come out and your ends are already dry and your hair is not, and you're like, Wow, my ends are really thirsty. But right now they're super nourished and they're wet, so that's good. So I'm gonna use a couple of products. This I've been using for 3-4 years now. It's the Miracle Leave-In Keratin spray. Does 10 things instantly. Maintenance of keratin straightening treatments, increases styling, perfect for all hair types, replaces lost protein, protects the natural keratin in hair, detangles, defrizzes, restores hydration balance, seals cuticles for extra silky hair, strengthens hair structure. Very interesting. But what I do is I spray it all over, and most importantly, in my ends. I use this all the time. And BB Invisible Oil Primer. Shake it, put it in your hand, a couple of spritz, and it's like a primer. You can use it how much you want. So the reason I do this movement with my hair is to bring the hair back to its natural curl. So you want to like have them dry up like this. Because when you brush it out, it kind of like straightens. So you want to bring all of it up and create like this natural volume. Alrighty. Second last product is a recent thing that I started using maybe a year ago. Rose water. It's also, I mean, it's English and German, but you can use it for the face, like a refresher, and for your hair. Basically leaves your hair feeling super nourished. It's just generally good for everything. I have a small bottle that I carry in the summers. It's just good to like replenish and like when your skin's feeling dry. So we're gonna do this whole thing again real quick. And last but not least, my favorite discovery. Oribe split end seal. So I'm gonna put, I lost that one. I'm gonna put 2 pumps. And it's just for split ends, so I just usually take it and like run my hand through the split ends. So this is my regular procedure at home when I'm traveling. All the products that I've used, I have them in the mini travel size, so I never have the problem of like running out or not being able to carry it. I hope you all guys stay positive, healthy, take care of yourselves, work on your mind, your body, your soul, everything. And if you have any questions, if you liked my video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. I am here for you, here to talk, so let me know your thoughts, let me know what you guys are currently going through, what are you feeling, and let's talk about it. Write it down in the comments and I'll be there for you all. I love you. You